Tonight, a story of survival. A woman goes public with her personal history of abuse in hopes of reaching so many others who suffer in silence.
Experts tell us one of every four girls encounters some sort of sexual abuse. For boys, it's one in five.
KETV News Watch 7's Julie Cornell reports on one woman determined to let others know they are not alone.
But I had to dig really deep and come to terms with what really happened.
With her life in photographs spread out before her, Deidre Wendt explains.
This one, still black and white, I was about 4 years old, which is about the age that I would have been when the abuse started.
A black and white photo, a sad little girl. She was adopted as an infant. Deidre says her childhood was a betrayal of trust and so much more.
We were raised on a farm, and so it was an animal game.
Okay.
That's how it started.
Deidre and her therapist say someone close to Deidre repeatedly sexually abused her for 8 years.
It came out that she had been abused many times.
I mean, does this look happy?
No.
No.
When she turned 12, the abuse stopped.
This one would have been 6th grade.
And Deidre did what a child does to protect themselves. She tucked away those memories.
What I did at that time, when it started when I was 4, I actually dissociated. And so, growing up, I thought I had a perfect childhood.
Child therapists say all the signs were there.
They're still having nightmares, they're still having, but they don't know what it's about. They're still having slips in their grades, they're still having behavioral problems. They're so anxious that, you know, they can't eat.
I was just a troubled child all the way through. I mean, I was the child that in class always acted out. I was boy crazy.
She married young, had a family, became a nurse, busied her mind and her hands. Child therapists say she lived with post-traumatic stress disorder, like that of a war veteran. Painting over the trauma can make it manifest into other troubles.
She just was hopeless. I would say she was hopeless.
Therapist Sally Kaplan, working with adult survivors of sexual abuse for 26 years. Deidre started therapy with her a couple years ago, after pain from a car accident triggered the trauma she endured as a child.
Once you've been physically, emotionally, or especially sexually abused as a child, that just becomes part of who you are. Can you become a survivor of that? Can you recover from that? Can you still live a rich and meaningful life? Absolutely. I know you can.
I was still broken. And I don't feel broken anymore. I feel victorious. I feel like I could do anything.
Part of that healing? Confronting her abuser, who wouldn't acknowledge the past.
He first wanted to know if I had any proof.
She was able then to get the courage to confront the people who had hurt her. And I think it opened up her family and opened up other survivors to come forward in a really powerful way.
The mother and grandmother speaking out to other survivors, lighting their way.
It may be very, very scary to tell somebody, and it may be scary if somebody doesn't believe you. But tell, keep telling until somebody believes you, because there is help.
Because when someone believes you and you work through the trauma, there's healing.
Support is the number one predictor of healthy outcomes.
Deidre, a frightened little girl, no more.
It's Julie Cornell reporting tonight. The Nebraska Child Abuse Hotline, 1-800-652-1999. In Iowa, it's 1-800-362-2178.
Experts encourage you to report an incident if you suspect a child is being mistreated. The warning signs often include a child who lacks proper hygiene or who may wear the same clothes all the time.
Abused children often miss school or daycare, act withdrawn, and are afraid of people.